व्हाट आर डिटर्मिनर्स? No need to open your books, just rough notebooks, that's all. What are determiners? What? Huh? Nee, what are determiners first? When we use, where we use? No. Determines what? Determiners are simple. Determiners are used before nouns. So it means they determine nouns, right? They tell us whether the noun is specific or we are talking in general. Got it? That's all. This is the function and definition of determiners. Determiners, what do determiners do? Determiners, first thing, they are placed before a noun. Got it? So they also determine whether we are talking about some general or something specific. Can you give any example of any determiner? They and the A, okay, A and A and the. These are articles, right? What? Little, a little, little, the little, yes, much more. Yes, this, that, these, those, much. Can you tell me the types? A and this, these are called articles. Then we have quantifiers. Then we have models. Models are verbs. Okay. Number, quantifiers, numbers, and then demonstrative, possessive. Right? Got it? Interrogative also. No, that is a type of sentence. Interrogative determiners, okay? But the thing that you need to keep in your mind is that it is always determiner plus noun. Okay? Is it okay? We have possessive pronouns also. We have possessive adjectives also. Adjectives can fall in this category because adjectives are also used immediately before a noun. ठीक है, clear? So let's start with, yes, Hardik, a few is also correct. Let's start with the exercises. You have to fill in the blanks with determiners. ठीक है, write down. But there isn't dash butter. But there isn't. That's all. Okay. Done? Yes, those who are online, I hope. Done? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Have you got dash oil? Enough? Some. Have you got the oil? Okay. Mostly when such type of questions are there, okay? When such type of blanks are there and we have questions, try to use any. You can use some also, but it depends. Okay? Enough is also. Okay? Have you got enough oil? Chalo, theek hai. Have you got any, some? Have you got little oil or little? How dash apples do you want? How many? But now here you cannot use any. Otherwise, with whenever we have questions or the sentence is negative. When the sentence is negative or we have interrogatives, right? So we use any. But in such type of sentences, we cannot use any. Okay? So how dash apples do you want? How much apples or how many? Many. Many means you can count. Okay? I could answer only dash questions. Few, a few. Few means almost zero. A few means yes, you have answered. Okay? Okay. I have answered only. When only is written, Bani, go with the negative one. Means positive plus negative, that a few, that is not completely positive. Okay? There are dash bright students in dash class. There are many. Okay. In the class, in this class. Okay? There are many bright students in this class, in the class, in my class. You can write. That is also correct. Do you have dash complaint against the clerk?
Any
complaint. There are dash eggs in the basket, but there isn't dash butter. There are many eggs. There are some eggs, right? But there isn't any butter. Okay? There isn't enough, no, go with any. Okay? And then is, there are dash birds on the tree. You can use any. There are many birds. There are some birds. Four birds. Many birds, some birds. See, so it means you can use more than one determiner for every blank, right? But it should be correct. And when you have such type of sentences, right? In which you can use, suppose there are some birds, there are many birds, right? Use only one determiner. Ek hi determiner likhoge, then you will get marks. Kai baar you write, what you do, you write two determiners. Usme se ek correct hota aur ek wrong hota. It means you are giving us the option to choose the correct one and give you the marks. Got it? So don't do this. Write only one jiske bare mein you are sure. Because this is the answer. Write that only. ओके नहीं हाउ मेनी एप्पल्स डू यू वांट आई थिंक इसका तो एक ही बन रहा है व्हाट हाँ चलो लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द क्वेश्चन आंसर्स नाउ हाउ द कैमल गॉट हिज हम जस्ट अ सेकेंड अनवे एनी यू कैन यूज एनी इनफ इज ऑल्सो करेक्ट ओके सो लेट्स स्टार्ट हाउ द कैमल गॉट इट्स हम सो आई होप योर बुक्स आर नॉट हाँ चलो फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन When did the animal start working for humans? When did the animals? Do you know the story of this chap? Do you know the story of this chapter? Okay, when the world began. Anyone who can tell me the story, summary of this chapter. What is the summary?
When animals start working for the men, while animals work for the
ओके हिज रिप्लाई वाज हम यस अवनी Huh. Which animal? No, name the animals that
ox,
dog, and
dog.
Blow karta tha, right? And then bull fight. Third animal. What is the name of the third animal? Fox. Is it fox? Yes. Third animal. You are saying fox or what? Horse. Horse. Is it horse? Okay, chalo. कैमल गॉट द हम बिकॉज ऑफ हिज बिहेवियर सो दिस इज दैट हॉर्स ऑक्स कैमल डॉग ओके देयर आर फोर बेसिकली फोर एनिमल्स मेंशन्ड इन दिस स्टोरी राइट एंड आउट ऑफ दोज फोर एनिमल्स Which animal was the laziest? Camel, right? So this story is all about how that camels, they have their hump, right? Why their back is like that. So what they have done, they have narrated in the story that the camel was very lazy and used to just relax all day. And because of that, is that behavior, is that nature, other animals they have to take up his responsibility also right so their work was they have to work yes double shift right so now what happened later on that they complained to the first they asked the man right but the man was not able to do anything then they what they did they yes they king of the desert it was a jinn and then jinn decided to teach camel a lesson so with every question whenever the jinn was asking anything and the camel was giving it answer in hum later on what happened because of his this reaction his this behavior he got he got the actual hum theek hai so camel was lazy. Let's see. There was a camel that was very lazy, and other animals did his work. One day they got frustrated and went to the king of the jungle. They got their reasons, and the animals were horse, dog, ox. Then they said that he always sees. Okay, yes, he admired his beauty also. Who admired his beauty? The camel used to admire his beauty. Yes, he was self-obsessed. Yes, correct. So let's start now. Where did the lazy animal live? Center of the desert. Okay. Then is, why did the other animals call the man? Why did the other animals? One by one. Chalo, yes. Camel was not doing his work, and so they called the, they were also fed up, they were also frustrated because they had to do, yes, okay. Then is, who was the in charge of all the deserts? How to write genie? G-E-N-I, genie, Aladdin wala genie, is it J, or is it, you all said genie, I also said genie. There, yes, this is also correct. Okay, okay, next is what was the camel doing when the jinn reached him? What was he doing? Wait, one by one. He was observing, okay, his own reflection. And what does this indicate? He was self-obsessed, right? And admired himself. Okay. Yes, one more. Okay, what do you learn from this chapter? Do your duty properly. That's all. If this question comes for 4 marks.
Ma'am, we should do our duty properly, otherwise we got punished. As a camel god, he was requiring his duty before.
Yes. Yes, teamwork, we also learn about teamwork, okay? Cooperation, teamwork, helping each other, this quality. Second thing is working hard, or we should do our part properly. Then any other thing? Yeah? What? Let's see what they have as answer. What is this? Camel was lazy. That never be lazy and do the work. That is. No, I am asking that what have you learned from this chapter? What have you learned from this chapter? This question can come for 4 marks. And be careful. Such type of questions are going to come. Not the direct questions. Just imagine ek ya do aayenge direct questions. Otherwise, you are not going to have direct questions. Nature. Okay, nature has its own ways to teach. okay. Don't be self-obsessed. Yes, we can admire, but one should not be obsessed, right? So, teen char jo cheeze hai, you have to write that, okay? I think this question is, can this story be factually true? You can write. Okay, one is, there are broadly two categories of workers. Those who prefer to do today what they can do tomorrow, and those who prefer to do tomorrow what they can do. You have to choose your category and then just decide which category is the best. Which category is the best? First, why? That definitely it will bother you only. You will have to work. Yes, pressurized, stressed. What? Enjoy properly. Okay, you, yes, definitely. When you have to do your work in hurry, you don't enjoy that thing and you don't learn anything from that particular work. Like they have to send their notebooks to me. Okay, and their activities to me. So definitely they are just going to copy and send. Now they won't learn anything. They won't enjoy the work. Yes, no. I'm not going to check the book now. Okay, chalo. All work is dignified. Do you agree? All work is dignified. We should respect every work, right? There is nothing like ye chota kaam hai, ye bada kaam hai, right? So there is no such thing as menial work. Okay, do you agree? Support your answer with reasons and then relate this to the chapter. Why do you think that every work is equal or every work should be respected? Every work has its own importance. Okay. Okay, hard work is the key in every type of work, right? Whether it is some office work or any other work. Work cannot define a person. Okay, can you relate this with the chapter? If we can, I think we can connect, because the camel there might be a reason that the camel avoids, or the camel was avoiding the work because he found the work lower or not respected or respectable work. So this might be the reason. You have to use the word might, that there are chances. You are not sure. If you want to connect it to the chapter, if such type of questions come, then use this model might, that you are not sure, but this can be the reason. Okay. Okay. Now one more. All work and no play. Is it a good idea? This question can come for your writing skills. It will pressurize your little, okay, young minds, and then both are important. Sports are more important. Have their own importance. We cannot compare, actually, I think, right? For this, we cannot compare. See, if this question comes in writing part, means B part, then you can use the examples from your text. Hafiz contractor, right? You can use that example. Okay, that he was, definitely he wasn't good at studies, but yes. So you can use this, that, but not properly, because uska jo context hai wo thoda different jayega, theek hai? And then yes, we should not compare that sports and education or sports and academics do with each other. Why we should not do this? Energy, they give energy also. Then your body is energized and you, I think that you feel active always. What do you say, Gurkaran? You play and then you come to attend the classes. Do you feel dizzy means you want to sleep or you are quite active? Active? Oh, that's good. Yes, you can give answer. Who is this? Bani Studies? Aray. Wait, let me read. Studies as well as play is important at studies. Make man perfect and play makes healthy. But I think there are so many chances nowadays in the field of games also. What do you think? International level pe players famous ho rahe hain. And I think they are earning more. No? Pulkit, stand up. Jaldi se ek minute ke liye bolna. You have to speak for 1 minute about same thing, the work and no play. Is it a good idea? Your time starts now. It's 9:02. All work and no play. Can sports and studies go hand in hand? Yes. Sure, Pulkit. You, whenever you go to play, after that you forget to do everything. Okay, Yashika's answer, yes, every work is equal. Okay, she is giving the previous answer. Every work is equal and it should be respected. Person should not be characterized with their behavior. Okay, person should be characterized with their behavior. In this chapter, the people also cut woods and animal transfer it to them. So in this past, there were no office. Yashika, I'm not getting the last part of your answer. If you have to connect it with the chapter, then with the animals, I think you can connect. Okay, one more thing that I want to tell you from this book. Ye jo think it over hai. Do go through these questions or statements, because these statements can also be framed as a question. Think it over. For supplementary reader, think it over hai na har jagah, har chapter ke baad think it over hai. So just read. If you will read, then you definitely you would have some idea ki agar ye cheez aayi to how to write. Ye jo abhi maine questions puche na, all work is dignified and all work and no play, this is given in this part. One more is there. He who struggles is better than he who never attempts. Again, a very good, I think, topic for paragraph writing, letter writing also. We can use this, that he who struggles is better than he who never attempts. Can you explain the meaning, just the meaning? Yes, struggling is definitely better. Yes, you will learn something if you struggle. If you try to complete your notebook, and if you are not able to complete it, like for Akshita today, she was struggling, but I think at the end she got the result, right? So it is like something is better than nothing. You will get something. Okay, so okay, bye.